I'm John Davies, I'm Chief Curator at Norwich Castle Museum, and I'm Chief Curator and Keeper of Archaeology, and I've been working at Norwich Castle Museum for about 20 years now. I've been involved in Norfolk's archaeology for about 25. I've seen a lot of changes and some really exciting discoveries over the years. My specialist areas are Late Iron Age, Late Prehistory, and we have some outstanding Iron Age and also Bronze Age collections at Norwich Castle. This particular trackway is very interesting to us because we do actually have tools of both of those periods, which may actually tie in with some of the tool marks and methods of construction that you're turning up here on the excavation.
Why are we in the pub?
Who would like to answer that question?
Well, I think it's easier on the site supervisor. You can give the best note.
Because it's absolutely raining cats and dogs, and if we didn't get off site, I think we might have been swept away into the Waveney. So we've retreated to the pub to save the archaeology and just do a bit of a debrief on the day.
What do you find most interesting about this dig, about the things which are coming up?
Basically, we find the things here that are missing from basically every dry land site anywhere. Instead of getting post holes, we're getting a post that would have gone in them, and we're getting the debris from woodworking. We're also getting to understand more about the technology and the skill that went into these sorts of things. Obviously, you don't get when you're just dealing with negative features on a standard archaeological site.
90% of our ancestors, sort of, particularly in the Iron Age, 90% of their sort of material culture was organic material, and of course on most archaeological sites that disappeared. So what we're talking about is the bits that are left behind, and here, because of the anaerobic conditions, we have that extra material preserved. So that's why it's particularly important. But also it gives you that extra knowledge, as Chris says, the wood technologies, the importance of doing of understanding these kinds of timbers and technologies.
Nothing's come off this site which would be preserved on a normal site. There's no bone, no pottery, no flint, no metalwork. So if this had been a normal site without the interesting preservation conditions, then everything we've dug up would have completely disappeared. There'd be no evidence here at all whatsoever. So having an opportunity to seize the other side of material culture is a really good opportunity.